better for the country if Ignatieff were rotting in the ground than if he were running for office.
These are real conservative books, unlike books by charlatans like Michael Ignatieff. It's funny how he's now teaching at U of T. He should have gone to teach at York with the rest of the turds.
No way he should come to power in a coalition with Michael Ignatieff. And the fact that he can pretend in this regard makes me think he's nothing but a pretender through and through. I know this is going to be controversial, you know, I kind of thought, should I say this or not? But I think the fact that he's been walking around with a cane is just purely an act. All of a sudden he shows up to Ottawa with a limp and a cane. The whole thing is just clearly an act, plain and simple. If he can lie about the budget and be a major spinster in this regard, why wouldn't he fake physical difficulty as well? It's a political decision, through and through, purely. Purely a charade, and I simply don't buy it. I mean, his wife is just as shameless, you know, as she's always been. You know, she's going around campaigning for Jack. She's like the Ava Brown for Canada, the NDP cheerleader.
It's an ugly truth that sometimes in the world we live in, self-defense takes the shape of a blowtorch or a crowbar. If no other avenue was left to me to exercise my freedom of speech, I, personally, would go the route of gasoline and finding a baseball bat with a nail on the end of it. In my humble opinion, it would be sensible to suggest that sometimes you can't make an omelet without flipping over a few cars. Quashing free speech is unacceptable and will not be tolerated. It is an outrage that you expect other people to pay your own way in what concerns only you and your sex life. Society shouldn't have to foot the bill for your contraception any more than it should pay for your porn, your sex toys, your romance novels, or whatever it may be. If you think you are entitled to this on everyone else's dime, then you are a... Hold off on the crack, Oxycontin, or meth for a couple days and buy the contraception yourself. For Malbama, getting money and pills to sluts like Sandra Fluke takes priority over job creation and economic relief. Mom Obama and the regime. 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 In my humble opinion, it would be sensible to suggest that sometimes you can't make an omelet without flipping over a few cars. Quashing free speech is unacceptable and will not be tolerated.